our fault. We had leads and couldn't hold on to it. So I don't think it was what other teams did. I just think it was what we did do. And we figured it out. One win led to two wins, led to three, and then you get your confidence back. I mean, we're dealing with teenagers. You know what I mean? They go through things in life, and I'm not making excuses, but you know, sometimes you just you hit that losing streak, and you try and get them back on the right page. Then you try and get them back on the right page. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. We kept working, we kept grinding at the staff. It's such a long season, man. It's a long season. You have your ups and downs.
Well, I was going to ask you too, like, how do you manage them when it comes to, you know, you say you're not as good as a 15-game winning streak, you're not as bad as like the first batch. How do you manage the player or the kid's expectations?
Well, they come up with their goals at the beginning of the year. They put it in their locker room. You know, one of those times when you're struggling, like, fellas, we didn't write these goals down. You guys did. So when things are going bad, you need to practice a little harder, work a little harder. And, you know, you ask so much of these kids when it comes to their time. But as we tell them, if you really want to be great, you got to do more practice than just when the coaches are around. You got to come in late at night or come in before practice and get shots or just work on your game. And to be honest, this group has been a group that's been in the gym a whole lot. And I think that's why we've had success into the late part of the season.
Thanks, sir.
Good meeting you, man.
You too.